Ladies and gentlemen, may I ask you to stand for the arrival of Alison, accompanied by her dad, Brian. Good afternoon again, ladies and gentlemen. Alison and Padraig are absolutely thrilled that you're all here to celebrate with them today. However, they're also aware that some of you may not yet be acquainted. So let's put that to rights now. Introduce yourself to somebody new, a stranger. Tell them how you're connected to Alison or Padraig, or both. And hugging is permitted. Wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. That seems to have gone well. Again, good afternoon. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all here today on behalf of Alison and Padraig, as we, on this very happy and special occasion, as we celebrate their marriage. Alison and Padraig wanted their wedding to be one was that especially appropriate for them, while at the same time being a personal and memorable day for everyone. Above all, they wanted each and every one of you to feel very much part of today's joyous occasion. My name is Emer Dillion, and I am a Humanist Celebrant accredited by the Humanist Association of Ireland and a registered marriage solemniser, which means that I am authorised to legally marry Alison and Padraig here today, and I was delighted to be asked to assist them with the planning of their wedding ceremony. Humanism is an ethical life stance that places human values at the centre of its philosophy. It's about compassion and reason. It's about taking responsibility and treating others with respect. At its core, humanism is about respect for others, whatever their class, creed, race, or sexuality. And it is inclusive. So whether you're of a humanist outlook or religious, or regardless of your worldview or philosophy, you're all very welcome here today. We're united in our common sense of humanity and community as we celebrate with Alison and Padraig. A humanist wedding is very much about the couple. It's about these two people celebrating their love for each other and making a commitment to each other in the company of those closest to them. The promises that Alison and Padraig will exchange here this afternoon in the presence of those they love and those whose friendship they enjoy and value will demonstrate their love and commitment now and for the future. Those of you here today have a special relationship with one or both of them, and your presence here this afternoon adds significance to this ceremony and support for their marriage. In the years ahead, as Alison and Padraig adapt to changing circumstances, it may be to you that they will turn to for company, support and laughter. In this event, your support is all the more important for you being here today. However, I would now like to pause to take a moment to remember those who are not with us. Particularly, we remember Alison's grandparents, John, Kathleen and Jerry. Also remembered are Padraig's parents, grandparents, Hugh, Pat, Joe and Martha. We can be sure that they would have been so very happy for Alison and Padraig on this, their wedding day. They are in our thoughts and remembered with love and affection. Let us pause. Thank you. The unity candle symbols the very essence of the wedding ceremony. So at this point, I'm now going to invite the mums to come forward. We have Tess, Tina, and Monica are all going to come forward and light a candle, each on behalf of the McKiernan and O'Gorman families. So, Tess, later on, after I pronounce Alison and Padraig married, we will ask them to light their centre candle. And it's not so easy. No. No, it's not. Are they all gone out? Okay. Now. Now, try again. Wonderful. Round of applause for candle lighting. All three are up and running now. Martin McGee is going to give us our first reading, and it's a wonderful one on the foundations of a good relationship. Hi, Martin. Do you want to read it from there, or do you have it?
No, I don't have it, no.
Oh, then.
Good to see everybody looking so well. Tan's done, and nails done, and nose hair's done. That's just pod. Yes, this is a little favourite of mine. It's a poem I wrote myself, but I see Seamus Heaney has copied it. It's a bit late now to talk to him about that, but okay. And this is called Scaffolding. I remember this from school. I think it's probably the only thing I do remember from school. Masons, when they start upon a building, are careful to test out the scaffolding. Make sure that planks won't slip at busy points, secure all ladders, tighten bolted joints. And yet all this comes down when the job's done, showing off walls of sure and solid stone. So if, my dear, there sometimes seems to be old bridges breaking down between you and me, never fear, Alison. Never fear. We may let the scaffolds fall, confident that we have built our wall. Okay. Thank you. Emer's just asked me, have I anything to add? I don't really have anything to add. This is all new for me. All I would say to Alison is, there's still time to change your mind, Alison. Padraig's a cyclist, and it's not easy getting married to a cyclist or being married to a cyclist, so I'm reliably informed. I do a wee bit of cycling myself. Some reasons I've heard not to be married to a cyclist is that chances are Pod has shaved his legs. So I believe it's also likely that his legs are softer than yours. He perhaps uses a more expensive moisturiser, usually delivered by Wiggle or Amazon up to the Commons in Newry. Apparently the postman's on first name terms with my sister Tess. she would say, another parcel today, Tess, for Padraig. But apart from that, you'll not have a spare room either, because it'll be like a bike shop. if the room I have is anything to go by. I did have another wee word to say, if that's all right. Emer?
No phones.
It's on silent. Seamus didn't take this from, Seamus Heaney that is, didn't get this. Marriage is like a tandem, Alison. Keep pedaling, or the one at the front shouts at you. I think it could be the one at the back shouts at you, but maybe one. You should promise each other to not only enjoy new adventures and explorations, but appreciate the same old routes you know and love. Especially up around Sleeve Galleon in Tyrone there. It's very nice. Marriage is a promise to each other. Turn my phone sideways. To endure the climbs so that you may chase the swoops and swerves of the perfect downhill track. Okay. And finally, the journey may be long and may have hills ahead. But if you climb together with love and passion, you will be able to achieve everything you both desire. A good expensive bicycle. That's it. All right. Thank you.
Yes, I can. Yeah, I do. I get the cycling thing. Yes, yeah, I have friends who cycle an expensive moisturiser. Yeah. I'm going to share some words with you on love and marriage. It seems appropriate for the day that's in it. Marriage is first and foremost a celebration of the love which two people share. It is a major and significant event in their lives and in the lives of those closest to them. Out of the routine of every day, something extraordinary has happened. It joins two people who trust the love that they have found. It is a partnership in which each can grow and be their true self while sharing in the development of the other. True love is not the first flaring up of the fire, new and bright and spectacular though that may be, but it is the careful tending that gives warmth and comfort over a long time. Marriage is a statement made by a couple to those around them of what they know, that they have found such love, friendship, and support, and they wish to share this for the rest of their lives. What really matters in an occasion like this, when a couple have decided to join their lives, is that they have absolute certainty that they are right for each other. They must be sure that their feelings will be lasting, not fleeting, and they must have thought about the future which stretches before them and the demands that that will make upon them. Padraig and Alison have thought about these things. They fully understand what is required of them as individuals and as a couple if this commitment is to last in the way they wish. They know that they can pledge themselves to each other with certainty and confidence. We don't know what the future may bring into your lives, but we do know that you two will meet life's challenges together. With that in mind, may you have patience in time of strain, strength in time of weakness, courage in times of discouragement, vision in times of doubt, and above all, a growing love. In the words of Robert Fulghum, shortly you shall say a few words to each other which will take you across a threshold of life, and things between you will never be quite the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. Our second reading is going to be given to us by Regina Parnell, a very good friend of Alison's.
Sorry, hi everyone, I'm Regina, friend of Alison's for a long time. Yeah. So I picked this reading because it made me think of Alison and Padraig and your journey together so far. So, time and again I've longed for adventure, something to make my heart beat faster. What did I long for? I never really knew. Finding your love, I found my adventure. Touching your hand, my heart beats faster. All that I want in all of this world is you. You are the promised kiss of springtime that makes the lonely winter seem long. You are the breathless hush of evening that trembles on the brink of a lovely song. The dearest things I know are what you are. Someday my happy arms will hold you, and someday I'll know that moment divine when all the things you are mine. Done.
Very high standard of readings. Alison and Padraig have decided to write letters to each other. They wrote letters to each other during the week about how they're feeling at the moment in the lead up to their wedding. And they are placing them in a special box, which has been made specifically for this. Pat, come forward and bring this extraordinary anniversary box and place it here on the table and hold it up for people to see, because it's just a stunning piece. Look. Woo! So you just place it there. Wonderful. I was playing with it earlier on. Have you got your letter? It's in here. I see. Okay. That's great.
I did last
night. Did you? Because I saw there was one and they said there was in. That's good. So we have one padlock here, as I say. Okay. And we have another one here. So I'm going to describe what the ritual is while the letters are. So we have one letter in here at the moment. We're waiting on another one. The courier is arriving with the other special delivery. The idea being that Padraig and Alison are going to place their letters in this box. It will not be opened until their fifth wedding anniversary, which will be on the 21st of September 2024. They can open the box on their fifth wedding anniversary and open those letters and read them and remember how they were feeling in the week leading up to their wedding. However, the box can be opened before the 21st of September 2024 in the event of a row, a whopping great big row. If it's a really A-star bust up, what we're going to do is that they then have permission to unlock the box and to sit down quietly and read those letters. It will give them a great footing as to how they had chosen this person as their life partner. So I'm going to hand you out. So, are there? Okay. So now I will put them in the box for you. And then we're going to lock the box. Have we got the locks open?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to put yours up there? And you put yours in there. Now it'd be really quite fun trying to find those keys in 5 years' time. Leave it in the lock. Well, let's do that just for the moment until you've decided what you're going to do. And that's going to be. I'm going to fix that later. 5 years' time, 21st of September 2024.
I'll have access to it before tomorrow.
Well, there's no wine in it, so you don't need to. Friends of Alison and Padraig's and family members are going to now give some wedding wishes. These have not been, they're surprises. So you're going to, I know what they're going to say, and they're lovely. But I'm going to now ask Mark Alison's brother, to just stand where you are, Mark, if you wouldn't mind. So just stand up there. You can stay there. And then Micheál, Padraig's brother. Excellent. Eve McKeown. Hi, Eve. Fiacra. Ah, you're all gathered over here. Good. And then who else? Louise. And Dee.
So I've chosen a poem which I feel is quite apt here. It's called Marriage is Madness. So I tweaked it. Yeah. So marriage is about giving and taking and forgiving and forsaking, kissing and loving and pushing and shoving, caring and sharing and screaming and swearing. It's about being together, whatever the weather, especially when she drives you to the end of your tether. It's about sweetness and kindness and wisdom and blindness. It's about being strong when you're feeling quite weak. It's about saying nothing when you're dying to speak. It's about being wrong when you know that you're right. It's about giving in before there's a fight. It's about the two of you living a life that's full of fun. And sure, there's plenty of people here you can call if you don't know how that's done. It's about never heeding advice that was always well meant and never counting the cost until it's all spent. And for you two today, it's about to begin. And for all that the two of you had to put in, some days filled with joy and some days with sadness, too late you'll discover that marriage is madness.
Mine's a bit shorter than Mark's. I might put a minute's silence in here.
What about the poem?
That's me, huh? It's just more of a message to say, look, we're all so happy for you both. It's great that you both found someone that you want to annoy for the rest of your life. For that reason, Alison, I'm glad you found Padraig. I wish you both lots of luck, patience and laughter. May you continue to travel the world together, conquer new challenges, but most importantly, your journey together continues from here, and we can't wait to share it with you. As they say in life, it's not where you go, it's who you travel with. Good luck.
So, as a chef, I thought it'd give you a bit of a recipe for love. So, combine two caring hearts, melt them into one. Add a lot of love, mix with respect and trust. Add gentleness, laughter, understanding, and not to forget a little bit of patience. Throw in a few kisses and an odd wee hug. Bake for a lifetime, and out comes what we have here today, a perfect couple.
Aww. Big song.
I'm Evie, Alison's friend for about 100 years. Sorry. That's why we look so good, isn't it? So, to the lovebirds, today is the day you will always remember. The greatest day in both of your lives. You'll start off the day as just two people in love. Oh my God, wedding. And end the day as husband and wife. So live happy forever as lovers and friends as it's the dawn of your new life.
Oh. She's pregnant.
Sorry, I'm pregnant. Thanks, Regina.
Oh, sorry to help you.
I know, it helped. As it's the dawn of your new life, where love never ends, but your new amazing venture begins. Ali and Padraig, you guys have truly something magical and special together. Cherish and nurture it always. Love you. Love you.
Hi, I'm Louise, a friend of Alison's for many, many years as well. And I'm just delighted to be here today to share this special moment. And with Alison and Padraig and everybody here today as well. The piece I chose reminded me of how Alison and Padraig first came together as friends. So it's about love and friendship. And as you may know, as I said, they became friends before. So love is friendship caught fire. Didn't want to say that, but... Love is friendship caught fire. It is quiet, mutual confidence, sharing and forgiving. It is loyalty through good times and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weakness. Love is content with the present, hopes for the future, and does not brood over the past. It is the day-in and day-out chronicles of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working toward common goals. If you have love in your life, any kind of love, it can make up for a great many things you lack. Alison Podrick's love is friendship caught fire.
No, it's for the videographer.
Okay. Can you hold it for me, please?
I will, of course.
I held a megaphone at a sports day. I'm a teacher last year, and some of the parents came over to me and said, next time maybe lower the volume down on the megaphone. So, I met Alison about 15 years ago. We did a fitness course together, myself, Alison, and Gina. And little did I think on that first meeting that we'd be best friends. And this is 15 years later. And a small other little thing as well, she introduced me to my husband. This is a small little bonus. So mine is short and sweet. Alison and Podrick, may life always bring you good friends and good health, a whole lot of laughter and a wee bit of wealth. A wide road before you and a bright sky above, warm times together with all those you love. And it is true, no matter how old you are, when you go out into the world, it's best to hold hands and stick together, whatever the weather.
Wonderful. Thank you.
We have now arrived at the most important part of today's ceremony, where I'm going to be asking Alison and Podrick to speak the words in which the presence of you all gathered here today will seal their union. I'm going to ask you to both stand facing each other. And I'm going to take these chairs away. Connor, could I ask you to remove them? No, we will. Hold on. Hold on. I am required by law to ask Podrick and Alison if they know of any impediment to their marriage. Podrick McKiernan, do you know of any impediment to your marriage to Alison O'Gorman?
I know of
no impediment to my marriage to Alison O'Gorman.
Alison O'Gorman, do you know of any impediment to your marriage to Porrick McKenna?
No, I know of no impediment to my marriage to Podrick McKiernan.
McKernan. Okay, McKernan. Okay.
Ask me to spell it now.
Do you, Porrick McKernan, take Alison O'Gorman to be your wife, to share in a relationship of love, tenderness, and laughter, to confide in and to trust above all others, to respect and stand by her in everything as an equal partner, but above all else to love and cherish her?
I do.
Do you, Alison O'Gorman, take Porrick McKernan to be your husband, to share in a relationship of love, tenderness, and laughter, to confide in and to trust above all others, to respect and stand by him in everything as an equal partner, but above all else to love and cherish him?
Thank you.
Alison, Porrick, I believe you have a few words that you'd like to say to each other. There are yours there. You're going first. Your personal vows. I'm going to step out.
Alison, my pride for you is unsurpassed and the happiness you bring is unending. Today, I make a promise to you that I will be there for you in all the good times and the bad. Today, I commit myself to you and promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you and comfort you. I promise to be faithful to you, to be true to you in good times and in bad, when life seems easy and when it seems hard. I vow to make you laugh, smile and always do right by you. I promise to cherish you, to support you and always love you.
Seems like you're going to do a lot.
What?
Seems like you're going to do a lot.
I do.
Babe. For those of you who know me, know I'm pretty risk averse. And for those of you who know you, know you're pretty risky. 1 year, 364 days ago, I took one of my biggest risks. going on a date with you. And despite it being the most horrendous first date, today I'm so happy and proud that we stand, or that that risk paid off, and we stand here today making a lifetime of commitment in front of our family and friends. My sister once said to me that she never set me up on dates because she didn't know what it was I was looking for. It's a lie. But when she met you, it all made sense. Our values and virtues align. Padraig, you're the untidy to my tidy, the unplanned to my planned. You're the humour to my resting bitch face. You're the soft to my hard. You're the yin to my yang. I'm so excited and proud to have you as my partner in life, and I promise that I will always continue to call you babe, appear interested when you talk to me about cycling, encourage you to be tidier, support you in bringing your ironing home to Tess, but seriously, what I am promising is to enter into our marriage with as much love, laughter and adventure that we've built our relationship on. I will always strive to be the yang to your yin.
So I'm now going to ask you to seal the commitment that you share with each other by the giving and the receiving of rings. The perfect circle of the ring symbolises eternity. The precious metal came from the ground as rough ore, was heated and purified, shaped and polished. Something beautiful was made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings made by imperfect beings. It is the process of making something beautiful where once there was nothing at all. Connor, you told me you had the rings. Do you still have them? Well, bring them here then. Padraig, take this ring and place it on Alison's finger and repeat after me.
I, Padraig.
I, Padraig.
Take you, Alison.
Take you, Alison.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I marry you.
I marry you.
And join my life to yours.
And join my life to yours.
Now, Alison, take this ring, place it on Padraig's finger, and repeat after me. I, Alison.
I, Alison.
Take you, Padraig.
Take you, Padraig.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I marry you.
I marry you.
And join my life to yours.
And join my life to yours.
May these rings stand for you as symbols of your love for each other, looking both inwards and outwards. An embrace that binds without imprisoning, a support that reassures without restricting. The wedding bands that Alison and Padraig have exchanged are confirmation of the vows that they have made. Alison, Padraig, you have freely consented to join your lives. You have pledged yourselves to each other by the exchanging of rings. And in the presence of everyone gathered here with us today, and by the power invested in me by the state, I am delighted to pronounce you husband and wife. And I think you might like to kiss. Earlier on, there were three candles lit. So now I'm going to ask you, by your mums, I'm going to ask you now to light your centre unity candle. As a married couple, as husband and wife, if you'd like to light your centre candle.
Words fall through me and all they mean.
So, Alison, I think it's in the words of Stevie Wonder, signed, sealed, delivered, he's yours. And we have another reading. Catherine, a very good friend of both, is coming forward to do a great reading. I love this one.
Hi, I'm Catherine, and Ali's one of my favourite human beings. I used to live with her, so I also know that Padraig signed up to a lifetime of cleaning and being tidy. What I'm going to read is an extract from Dolly Alderton's book called Everything I Know About Love, and I've made a few tweaks. I know that love can be loud and jubilant. It can be dancing in the mud and pouring rain at a festival, and shouting, "You're amazing," over the band. It's introducing them to your family and friends and basking in pride as they make them laugh and make you look lovable just by dint of being loved by them. It's laughing until you wheeze. It's waking up in a country neither of you have ever been in before. It's jumping into the freezing 40 foot together on Christmas Day. It's walking along the street together on a Saturday night and feeling the entire city is yours. It's a big, beautiful, exhilarating force of nature. And I also know that love can be a pretty quiet thing. It's lying on the couch together, drinking tea, talking about where you're going to go that morning to drink more tea. It's folding down pages of books you think they'd find interesting. It's hanging up their laundry when they leave the house, having forgotten to take it out of the washing machine. And especially for you, Ali, it's putting the bins out without being asked. And it's the texts. Hope today goes well. Thinking of you today. How did today go? And picked up Blue Roll. I know that love happens under the splendor of moon and stars and fireworks and sunsets. But it also happens when you're cleaning the kitchen worktops, stuck in a traffic jam, cycling uphill, or coming in your front door from a walk in the rain. Love is quiet, reassuring, relaxing, pottering, pedantic, harmonious hum of a thing. Something you can easily forget is there, even though its palms are outstretched beneath you in case you fall.
It didn't give you right in front of me. Too emotional.
Just before my closing words, ladies and gentlemen, just to say that Alison and Borek are going to be wrestling with the weather. So they're going to go straight out and have photographs taken. You're all invited to go over to the main house and have drinks and canapes, and they will then join you after they've had their photographs taken. Okay. So to send you on your way, I'm going to conclude with some closing words. Alison and Padraig, go forward in your life together with the good wishes of those you love ringing in your ears. Go forward to a life of joy, fulfillment, of tolerance, of peace, and of tidiness, obviously. Remember this day, those who came to wish you well, the words that you have spoken, the emotions that you feel, and the rings which symbolize the meaning of this occasion. May your home be a place of happiness for yourselves and for all family and friends who enter it. May your love for each other continue to grow. May it deepen and increase so that you may be forever as you are now, happily in love and glad to be married to one another. So if you'd like to stand, I'm going to ask you to face your guests and I will introduce you to your guests. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present for the first time husband and wife, Alison and Padraig, who are now going to lead you off to the festivities.